Hello again, Chords and Notes Nation. I'm Brian. My coffee's in there. I'm trying something brand new today. And one of the comments that I received recently, someone had requested Michael Jackson. I never thought that I would be reacting to Taylor Swift songs, and now I certainly never thought I would be reacting to Michael Jackson songs. I think the list is going to continue to grow, don't you? But I appreciate that you guys are intrigued with how I'm going to react to music that you love. I also invite you to check out the other videos that I've put on there, on my website, my YouTube channel, and check out the songs that I like to share as well. It's all about community, it's all about sharing. Sharing is caring, right? And I will share with you, and you will share with me, and we will be Chords and Notes Nation together and have fun. Now, let's talk about Dirty Diana. Well, let's listen to it, then I'll talk about it.
Yeah.
know I've heard that song at some point in my life. I'm trying to pinpoint it, but especially with the chorus and the way he sang it, it just started, light bulbs started going off that, hey, you know, you've heard this at some point in your life. I can't remember where, though. Yeah, you know what I liked about this song is, you know, his vocals, his ability to sing has never been in question, ever. Performer from day one. But there's his style of singing. It was just so fresh and so... What's the word? He sang with authority, and he put so much into what he did. You don't become the king of pop for no reason. Well, maybe today they crown, you know, the record companies crown this person and that person based on whim and record sales and that sort of stuff. But we're talking about a different era, and the few songs that I have heard of his over the years, one of the things that always stood out is that he had organic musicians behind him. It wasn't always synthesized stuff like it is today, and he's always had guitar players who they never held back in his songs. They had their place, their instrument's voice would not outdo his, and it would supplement the musical arrangement, but it was there, and it had attitude, and it was... was more like metal guitar playing than anything. And I'm just thinking of songs like this one or Beat It, that sort of thing. And I know he's done a lot of different types of songs as well. So I'm going to reserve my statements for just the songs that I do know and that I have heard. Dirty Diana, I wonder if this was about a specific person or if it was just conceptually about a type of person that musicians meet on the road. Irregardless of which way it is, she sounded pretty superficial, right? But it sounded like he fell in the sense that she got what she wanted, right? There's a lot of implications in this song as well. But, and this is a toe-tapping song. You know, it's one of those that has a hook to it that brings you into the song musically and also has that lasting power of being memorable because of that hook, which to me the hook for this song was the chorus and how it was sang and that sort of thing. So that's all I have for Dirty Diana. Gee, I wonder if that's all she has for me. Oh. All right, anyways, I'm being a goofball. There you go. There we have it. Dirty Diana. If you want any more Michael Jackson, feel free to request, but feel free to share with your friends, subscribe, click the notification icon so that you see all of what I produce. And I will be talking to you in the near future. Take care wherever you are. Take care of yourself. Take care of each other. And take care of Dirty Diana.